In today's internet tech-driven world, we have all come to expect information at our fingertips at any time. From ordering anything imaginable on Amazon to connecting all our smart devices to our phones, it all simply works. But how is it that all these devices and services are able to communicate and connect so easily? It all has to do with something called an API. API stands for Application Programming Interface, and it is the way digital services and devices allow applications to share data with one another. APIs run behind the scenes and automate the request and response of data. The result is seamless integration in one application for the user. If an API works correctly, the user never even knows it's there. For an easy thought experiment, let's say you're looking to talk to someone in a business. You go to the receptionist and ask to speak with the person. The receptionist then calls this person and communicates that you wish to speak with them. They tell the receptionist that they'll be out soon. The receptionist returns and tells you that the person will be out soon. The receptionist, or API in this case, receives the request, processes the information with the person you're looking for, and retrieves the response, delivering it back to you. Now let's take a look at how this works in a digital landscape. Think of the popular Google Maps. They allow the public to access their map data via their API to integrate it into any application. As Google updates their map data on their servers, the API gathering the data will receive this update as well. This gives any application access to the updated information, such as the very popular Uber app. Uber gives rides to customers based on location and how long the trip will take. With the API, they can then calculate routes, fees, and any traffic issues based on the information. Now, in order for an API to work across multiple developments, there are technical considerations such as the API's architectural style. This could include REST, push, streaming, RPC, native, browser, indirect, or GraphQL. We also have to consider what type of API it will be: internet, browser, product, standard spec, or system embedded. And of course, we have to consider the API's purpose and the service it will be providing. The process would appear seamless to an end user, regardless of whichever of these parameters are being used. At its core, APIs have three main parts. They act as the messenger, collect and process the data, and finally return the response to the request. Now, APIs are very common across applications, servers, and basically anything digitally connected to each other. The true strength of an API for businesses is that it becomes an open platform to build on. This provides value for others, enabling them to develop and integrate at a faster rate. In fact, here at KMC Controls, we have published our own API for our KMC Commander IoT platform. Our API allows for simple integration between your building's data through KMC Commander, making it available to any application you want, whether analytics package, ERP, or the like. Perhaps you're building custom apps for a client or integrating new features into something that you've used for years. APIs enable this data to flow seamlessly into other platforms of your choice, securely and reliably. Of course, this is just the surface of APIs, but understanding what they are and having a knowledge of what they can do for your business is invaluable. As integration of information technology and operational technology continues to grow, the connectability and simple communication between IoT devices will be critical to successful implementation. To learn more about our IoT platform, KMC Commander, or any of the solutions from the building geniuses at KMC, visit us on the web at kmccontrols.com.